Okay, so apparently my webcam works.
Hey
everybody, I just wanted to give y'all a much needed update video. However, I want to preface things by saying, if you at all care about the future of this channel, or anything about the channel, have any investment, please stick to the end of the video because I'm gonna have a few call to actions as well as some things I'm gonna need for you guys to do if you want to participate in the unsubscribe way of life.
Alright, now lose it.
So addressing the elephant in the room, why didn't this video come out sooner? Well, quite frankly, it's a lot of things that mostly boil down to things like procrastination, as well as just kind of a bit of insecurity. Like, before I did this video, I wanted to sit down and outline everything I wanted to say, but every time I would just sit down and try to write that outline, I just would end up staring at my computer screen for like 30 minutes and then just get frustrated and work on something else. But I finally just decided, fuck it, so here I am. I apologize for the shitty video quality. I was thinking of doing this like on a video camera, but I didn't really want to take the time to try to schedule that out with my cameraman for just an update video. So I figured I'd try the webcam out, but it looks really badly. But here's the thing, what else am I gonna do? Like, I could do like my little anime avatar thing, but I wanted to be more personal with this since this video is a little bit more important. But going back into the other elephant in the room, the title of the video. And the title for this video is not exactly clickbait. Basically, I'm going on hiatus for anywhere from 2 to 8 months. I don't know the exact time frame, but I would guess no shorter than 2 months, and hopefully no longer than 8 months. There are several reasons for that hiatus, but I want to also include the disclaimer that a short film contest entry, like for Monkey Shit, would not be part of that hiatus because, you know, that is scheduled on a external contest, because that's on an external contest that I can't control the scheduling of, and I've been in every short film contest so far, so if he does one in summer, I'm probably going to do something for that. But going into the reasons for the hiatus, there's several, starting out with one. I've been very busy lately, and my responses on certain social media is kind of indicative of that, but I've been very busy, and basically I need this hiatus primarily because I need to get my personal adult life in order. That means stuff like internship that I'm currently doing, getting a real job with real money, moving out of here, and honestly, I burnt myself out really badly with this channel back in December. If you remember, that was when all of the album lists were dropping. That's when Bible Man and Korra and a bunch of other shit was dropping. And I was trying to get shit out before certain holidays, and I burnt myself out really badly to where I wanted to just give up on the channel altogether. So another primary reason for wanting this hiatus is not only so I can get my personal life and, you know, professional life in order, but my YouTube life needs a breather if I'm going to continue, because what I've been doing has not exactly been working. And the third main reason is that for what I want to do for the channel, I am not interested in wasting energy. I want everything I do from here on out to be very deliberate, and that's going to require some extensive planning, especially with things like lore, and as well as sorting through ideas and figuring out which ones I should keep, which ones I should change, and which ones I should just can altogether. Like, there's been a lot of videos over the course of this channel that have they've been scripted, and they've just gotten thrown out because they're just absolute trash. So I'll need to get my life, internship, career, all that in order. I need to rest on this YouTube shit a little bit, and I want to plan out everything. Basically, I'm overwhelmed by what I want to do, and I feel very underwhelmed by what I have done. As far as the first half of that, being overwhelmed by what I want to do, it kind of requires a little bit of explaining. So, I've been making stories since I was 7. And one of the primary ways that I deal with stress in my life is I always have stories working on in the back of my head. I've been doing this ever since I was 7. And a lot of it has been the same stories piling on top of each other. And so I am at a point right now where there are so many ideas that I want to transport from in my mind to in the ether of the world into something that people can consume as a product of art. And there's just so much bullshit that even as much as I've narrowed down in these 7 years, like, I'm adding to the pile faster than I'm taking off of it. And to kind of clarify some of the stuff that I want to do, and let me pull it up real quick. Basically, I have upwards of 6 to 7 comic series that I want to work on. I have a good 2 or 3 shows, maybe 3 or 4 shows that I want to work on, and I have 7 movies that I want to work on. And that's not including the albums that I've planned out and worked on, like concept albums, which I have 3 concept albums, 1 comedy album, and the mixtape I'm currently working on, all in the works in my head, as well as that's not including all of the podcast projects and especially lore and short films that I want to do with this channel. For instance, I probably have a good 30-something videos lined up for the channel, and that's just the important shit. So between all of that, everything that I want to do, it might take me the rest of my life just to get that shit done. If I'm even successful at all getting that shit done. Because, you know, movies, shows, comics, videos, all this stuff takes time and money, which I'm running out of time, and I never have money to begin with, so it's kind of this, once again, a little bit of a contradiction where I just add to the pile faster than I take off of it, and when I do take off the pile, I'm not really happy with it. I'm honestly really disappointed in the output of my channel over the course of its lifetime. And to go into that, you look at some of the videos that I would consider my best. Things like, okay, outside of short films, you have The Legend of Cunt Book 2. That is one of my, in my opinion, one of the videos that had the most editing going into it, right? But the issue is, even that video has glaring editing issues. Like, I made fun of it in my Slim Shady retrospective video, where my lip syncing was just so fucking terrible. And beyond that, it's a 50-minute video when it should have been cut down to like a 30-minute one. Like, I'm really bad about cutting out shit that is just doesn't need to be there. It's just so full of filler. And that's one of my best videos, you know? I look at any single one of my videos, no matter how much praise it gets, and it's just full of issues and problems that could have so easily been solved if I had just given them the time that they needed. And that's not even going into short films, which are just another disaster altogether. Whether it's the frame rate issues that Buttface and the Gooch opening and ending videos have that I can't fucking figure out how to get that goddamn frame rate right. Whether it's, Dr. Bozo's abortion, Wacky Abortion Emporium, was murdered by the audio in that. It is unwatchable because of that audio. Daughter had major problems with how it was made, even if the punchline ultimately works. Heavy Mental, I'd say, is probably my best made short film, but ultimately it suffers by I made a script about my best friend that nobody's gonna find as funny as me, itis. So it's like every single video on this channel. Like, there's some that I appreciate more than others, like the BoJack video, or like the Pink Season video, or the Korra videos, but that's the shit that nobody pays attention to. And maybe it's because it's not captivating enough, I don't know. But with any case, I'm just really not happy with the output of my channel. And I feel like deadlines have really been the bane of the channel. And I've decided no more hard deadlines. By hard deadlines, I mean, I was trying to get videos out before Halloween because the order of the videos was very important. So, for instance, with the story and shit that I want to do, it's very important that you have it in this order where you have the top 10 albums list, then you have the Pink Season video, then you have the Korra video, then you have the Bible Man video. It's very important that it's in that order, but I wanted all of that done before Halloween because I had a Halloween video that just got canned, and then I needed it out before Christmas, and then I was stressing just to get that done. So holiday videos are not going to be connected to anything else, and I'm not going to work with any hard deadlines. Now granted, if I start making part-time or full-time money with YouTube through the content I'm making, then I will be more dependable with deadlines and with quality of output. But quite frankly, I'm tired of rushing out videos that just end up crap. Like, Bible Man should not have been as rough and edited as it was. It should have been way more polished. And I just feel really disappointed that it wasn't, you know? So I feel I need to give these videos the time of day that they deserve and not release half-finished bullshit. And so when I do come back from the hiatus, don't expect, you know, really consistent content, because until I start making a career out of this, I've already tried working the algorithm by posting a video every month or every day of the month, or, you know, be consistent with that, but it just hasn't worked. So if I'm not captivating a larger audience through, you know, like uploading consistently, then I need to make great uploads that really catch whoever watches it and makes them subscribe. Another thing that's really brought me down lately is, you know, I told myself at the end of the year, if I wasn't back to where I was before Kevin deleted my channel, I would stop YouTube, and I'm not doing that, obviously. I'm still here. Like I said in, the I'm Back 2 video, I'm still doing this shit. You know, I'm still committed to doing this shit. But it's really demotivating when I am still behind where I was back in April of last year. Today's April 1st when I'm recording this, and it's been about a year, or a little less than a year, since my channel got deleted, and here I am, still under 3,000, still under the almost 7,000 I had, and growth is pretty much dead. Like, very little, if any, growth at this point. And this complaint might not hold up in a few months if I get lucky or whatever. Probably not a few months if I'm not uploading, but, you know, YouTube's weird. But with any case, going back to the Patreon thing. Patreon donations are not necessary during hiatus. That should be pretty obvious. But I will be hustling my Patreon, or more likely a Subscribestar, since Patreon is fucking gay. And I'll be hustling that after my return, because I want to start justifying putting time into this channel, because I love putting time into this channel and making shit for you guys, for me, you know? But I can't do it for free, as much as I want to, as much as I have up till this point. So I really need to make some sort of return on this, because I am in debt with this channel. I've probably dumped like 700 bucks in this, and have probably gotten very little in return, like 15 bucks in return. Which, I mean, to some people may not sound like a lot. Oh, 700 bucks, but, you know, it is what it is. And I don't regret making the videos I've made, but at the same time, I need to be smart with my life, because I'm at a point right now where I need money. You know, it's kind of important to being an adult, you know? I can't keep being immature and focusing on my passions rather than on my responsibilities, you know? But anyway, let's go into the logistics of this. What do I need to get done before I return from hiatus? Well, there's about 5 things. 1, I need to finish my internship, which finishes in May, and get my degree. That'll be done by May, so no new content until at least May is passed. 2, get a higher paying job, jump on my student loans, and move the fuck out. I'm hoping to move out around December. I'm planning on getting that job between May and June. And, you know, student loans, I'm just gonna keep working on them. And I also want to build up savings so that, you know, I'm being financially responsible and bullshit like that. But that's the adult external life stuff. But have the channel's future extensively planned out, and the majority of major scripts written will be the third thing that needs to get done. 1, it all planned out, major scripts written. 4th thing is finish 8 tracks. That is going to be my mixtape that I'm working on. And I want it completely done and polished. I don't want to release crap. I want it completely polished, and that's going to be the first thing I release on my return. So once you see the first track drop from 8 Tracks, the first single, that's when you know I'm back, and that's going to be my big return. You know, I have a little song about it called Comeback, and boy, I really want to come on y'all's backs, if you know what I'm saying. The last thing is I want to have a log of completed videos to drop afterwards. So, for instance, while I said I'm not going to worry too much about, you know, weekly content, when I come back, I do want to have, like, a good month and a half to 2 months of completed videos to drop one every week. So maybe a good, like, you know, 6 to 8 videos done that I can, you know, drop and be ahead of myself so that you guys don't have to wait as long, even though I'm going to be taking longer for the videos. So going back into what can you expect at my return, 8 Tracks will be the first thing to drop. I have several video essays as well as some skits and reviews leading up to a Legend of Cunt finale that only a few people will care about, but you should watch my Legend of Cunt videos. I'm very proud of them, and this last one is going to be channel lore related. And I'm going to have a concrete plan for the direction of the channel and its lore, which is going to get pretty fucking crazy. And going back to the overwhelm thing, I'm very overwhelmed by the lore I want to do for this channel because, quite frankly, it may be impossible to do what I envision doing. But if I'm successful, then shit. I may be having the greatest YouTube lore of all time. If I'm successful, which I may not be. And going back to some of the other projects like the comics and all, that's all intertwined, and this is YouTube lore is connected to all that. I'm working in this huge fucking extended universe of bullshit that it will be fucking incredible if I can pull it off. If. And I guess that's what we're gonna have to see. And lastly, for those of you who stayed to the end of the video, thank you. I need something from you. I need 3 things from you, specifically. 1, stay subscribed to unsubscribe. Stay subscribed to this channel. I will be back. I'm not leaving for good. This video title does not say goodbye forever. It says goodbye ... for now. Stay. I'll be back. I'll have good shit. I'll have better shit than I've ever had before coming to this channel. I promise that. But you need to stay. Like, it doesn't cost anything to just stay subscribed to it, you know? The second thing, subscribe to my second channel, previously called Jedi Masturbates, but now called, Unsubscribe the Squeakquel, I believe is what I named it. And you're going to need to subscribe to that channel if you at all care about anything about this channel. The reason being, that's where all the podcasts are going. That's where all the live streams are going. That's where all the shit posts are going. That's where all of, like, the little dumb videos are going. And I'm going to be using that channel more often than I'm going to be using my main channel. My main channel is going to be the good stuff. This is going to be the podcast and all that shit. So if you like following me, that's where you want to be. That rhymes. Yeah. This is going to be my Monkey Jones 2, back when that was a thing. And like I said, I'm going to be doing live streams on there, so I'm not going to be doing live streams on main channel anymore. It's going to be all there, so if you want to catch those, be there. As far as podcasts, I'm going to be jumping really hardcore on podcasts in the next few weeks. And more specifically, I have a lineup of a few podcasts that I think y'all are going to care a little bit about, at least 1 or 2 of them. And those podcasts are, let me pull up that list so I don't forget any. First we have Go to the Movies, which is my Is It Kino ripoff podcast, where I watch a movie with somebody, or maybe just myself, and I talk about it. It's not necessarily new movies, it can be new movies. My goal has been to do it with every new movie I watch, but that has not been successful at all. But I want to jump back into it. I need to catch up on some. Like, I watched Me, Myself, and Irene, and I wanted to do one on that. I watched The Book of Life. I want to do one on that. Endgame is coming out. I want to do one on that. Spider-Verse is my favorite movie currently, so I definitely want to do one on that. But I need to catch up on that shit. So if you want to hear me and somebody else, it rotates, talk about movies, watch Go to the Movies. The first episode we did on Avengers Infinity War in particular is really funny. I would check that one out if you've seen Infinity War. It has spoilers though, beware. The second podcast is Solving the Hard Questions, which is actually a podcast I bought from E-Rich in exchange for editing a few Soy Wars episodes for him if he ever fucking gets to them. Basically, Solving the Hard Questions is a ripoff of Monkey Jones, an insufferable social media argument podcast. Basically, you have me as the host and then co-hosts Brant or Midas and How To from the Pulse of Music, and basically us and a guest each bring a question to the table, and then we have to give our most shitpost answer for that question and then argue our points, and then the audience decides, you know, standard fare. The third podcast is going to be one that I do with Midas or Brant, and it's going to be called The Third Bomb. It is a anime review podcast. It is not going to be very consistently uploaded because we're going to watch the entire series. You know, we're ripping off Monkey's anime retrospective or anime spectrum podcast, but we're not just watching one episode, so it can't be that often, and it takes time to finish series. He's been hounding me to finish Cowboy Bebop, but I'm two episodes left, so we're going to do the Cowboy Bebop as our first episode. But if you like anime, if you're a weeb, watch The Third Bomb, because we have Nagasaki, Hiroshima, and then anime. The third podcast, even though that it was the one we just talked about, the fourth podcast is Improv RPG, which is this little game I have. It's going to be great, because what you do is you have a dungeon master who carves up a story. Then you have 2 to 4 players, and each of those players has to survive the story by making decisions, and the game master decides whether the decision works or not. The game master's goal is to make the funniest story possible. Each player's goal is to survive in the funniest way possible, and you have different situations like zombie apocalypse, race war, battle royale, all kinds of shit. It's gonna be fucking great, and I'm not ripping off Monkey in this one. Shut up, phone. Take care of that. Hold on. Professional work. I'm not even going to edit this out. Fuck all of you. But I'm not ripping off the Monkey podcast for once. I'm actually going to be ripping off the Mars Squatch and Alien Hypothesis episodes of Sleepycast, which is my favorite podcast, and you should check it out if you haven't already. I'm also going to be doing a Kanye retrospective, sort of, not an actual retrospective, because you should be checking out Untitled Doc's channel for the greatest Kanye West retrospective, but instead of doing a video series, we're instead going to do a podcast where Papa Cherry and I talk about each one of his albums and just kind of throw things back and forth. It's a podcast. We're not stealing Untitled Doc's thunder. Check out Untitled Doc, but I also wanted to, you know, talk about Kanye because I kind of like Kanye West, you know? And then we'll have the live streams, and that's, you know, pretty much it. That's the podcasts I have lined up. There may be more, but the 5 or 6 podcasts is quite a bit to balance, so I feel like I should probably just stick with those, honestly. And where does that leave us? Okay, so what I need from you, I need you to stay subbed to this channel, subscribe to my second channel, and I'm fucking serious, because if I get more views on this video than I get subscribers on my second channel, then we're gonna have a problem, because that's where I'm gonna do all my bullshit. Excuse me. And then the third thing I need from you is follow me on Twitter. Links in the description. There's updates, shitposts, and politics if you don't like one of the three. Okay, fine. You don't have to follow me on Twitter. But it's down there if you want to. And then the third thing, other part of the third thing, is join the Discord server. We have a lot of fun there. It's terrible. There's a link down there. Yeah, no, it's fucking terrible, and you'll probably love it. So check it out, boys, and that's pretty much it. Do those three things for me, I'll do the rest for you, and I'm gonna get to work, guys, so once again, sorry this took out so long, sorry I'm gonna be gone for a bit, but hopefully it'll all be worth it. Hopefully I'll get my life together, I'll get the channel together, and I'll have some good shit cooking for you guys. So if you want to talk to me, hit me up on Twitter, Discord, subscribe to my second channel, and I'll see y'all when 8-Tracks drops. Peace out. Oh, wait, no. This is the Tim signing, the Fuckboi Philosopher Crap God unsubscribe, signing out forever.